Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. So let's talk a little bit about the recent ransomware attacks around the world. A few of you have asked me about these. And basically this is an attack on computers and systems around the world that infected some Windows computers when people clicked on links, downloaded some things that they shouldn't have, and it's been dubbed WannaCry. And it's been particularly effective, and it's gotten a lot of news because not only does it infect the computer where somebody maybe installed something that they shouldn't have, but it's also affected other computers on the same local network. But the important thing to know about WannaCry for Mac users is that it targets Microsoft Windows. So it's not a threat to Mac computers. Now, this doesn't mean you shouldn't be concerned about ransomware. It's just this particular attack called WannaCry doesn't affect Macs. But there's important lessons for us to learn here, and we should take this opportunity to learn a little bit more about ransomware. Basically how it works is that once your computer is infected, it will wait usually a few days so you don't know you have this, and then all of a sudden it will encrypt all of the data on your computer and you can't access it at all. You can check out this Wikipedia page for all sorts of details on this particular type of ransomware, WannaCry, and ransomware in general. And basically you have to pay some money to get a code that then decrypts all your files so you can get them back. Of course there's the question of whether or not once you pay the money you'll actually get the code, whether it will work, whether you might not be subject to attacks in the future, that kind of thing. But fortunately there are a few things you can do to protect yourself against this. And as Mac users, we haven't been affected by this, but we should be prepared for perhaps an attack in the future. So how do you protect yourself? And it turns out it was really easy for anybody to avoid WannaCry. All they needed to do was make sure that they had their computer updated, because this vulnerability was known a while ago. And Microsoft offered an update, and it was only people that did not apply this update that had the problem. So it's important that you do system updates. Now I know there's a lot of reasons people don't do system updates. They see an update and they want to put it off, they're in the middle of something, and they decide not to do it at the moment, or maybe they're afraid that it might break something that they're doing right now, maybe some software they're using, or maybe they don't like how things change every once in a while with updates, maybe something looks a little different, works a little different. But it's so important in today's world that you keep your system updated. It's critical, because just like with this ransomware attack, which is hurting lots of people around the world, there are threats out there, and the defense against these threats is to have an updated system. In the past, Apple's been very fast at updating macOS to make sure it protects against threats like these, but you have to apply the updates. If you decide not to do them, then you could end up being a victim like this. So in addition to doing this kind of thing, you want to make sure that you follow some basic rules. Like for instance, don't download things you don't trust. You can download stuff from the Mac App Store, but be very, very cautious downloading something from outside the Mac App Store. And if you're not sure, just don't do it. Now obviously there's some companies like say Adobe, Microsoft, etc. that are big companies and and you might have been using their software for years. But just make sure you're downloading directly from them, not from a site that might be masquerading as them. And then of course keep your software up to date, not just your operating system, but all of your apps and everything like that, because even apps themselves may have security fixes inside of some of their updates. So you want to make sure you're running the most recent versions of those. And then pay attention to the news, because every once in a while there may be some important thing you need to know where you can update your computer quickly or avoid a problem, and you want to keep yourself informed. So you want to do that. And of course I'd say the fourth thing is to keep a good backup. Having Time Machine backup is absolute necessity for Mac users. And so far ransomware attacks don't seem to affect Time Machine backups, that kind of thing, but it's possible technically that even Time Machine backups could be vulnerable to this. So you may even want to consider an online backup, which would be a lot tougher to harm in terms of a ransomware attack. So there's some advice for you. Nothing to worry about from WannaCry for Mac users since it's Windows software. But you do want to make sure that you keep your OS and your apps up to date to prevent anything like this from happening in the future. We'll be right back.